I think we lived here maybe for just about, it's been about 4 or 5 years. I have a scar on my chin from watching, we were watching Batman downstairs in the basement. The basement had a cement floor, and I remember spinning around on the banister and going, Batman! Spinning on the banister, falling off, slamming into the cement floor, cutting my chin open.
It was a good childhood.
You know, it's funny, I have lots of memories, but I don't remember where my bedroom was. Down right at the end of the street, I can't remember the family's name, but they used to have pellet rifles. And I remember, you know, as a 5-year-old, just shooting beer bottles off of the fence with pellet rifles. When I was 8 years old, my grandmother, for my birthday, gave me a 6-inch Bowie knife. And I think times have changed. I can't imagine, you know, giving my son now an 8-inch Bowie knife to play with. But in some ways, you know, I think as a parent, you know, we're constantly reading in the newspapers these, you know, things that happen, and sometimes I question whether things are as bad as they seem, or if media outlets are just kind of selling newspapers, selling their television show or whatever. But because, you know, when I was a kid, I remember, and some of you probably had similar experiences where, you know, on the weekends I would get up in the morning and I'd have a bowl of cereal, and then I'd get on my bike, and then I'd leave the house and I'd go to the park and I'd ride around. I grew up in Winnipeg. I'd ride around Assiniboine Park and the trails by myself. And then when I got hungry, I'd come home and I'd eat, and then I'd go back out on my bike. And I just don't think, that happens very often now. You know, we're so conscious of where our kids are, but... Played a game in my younger life, a lot like Twister, but with a knife. I threw the point into the ground to bend my brother's body round. No one bled, and if they did, they didn't cry. Don't recall a watchful eye. I think we led safer lives when we played around with knives. I left the house for hours on end, home to eat then out again. Raced around the monkey trails with my back step brakes that never fail. I rode through the woods alone, out of sight and far from home. I think I got a richer life on my rusting no-speed bike. When patience broke, I was pulled to my room, and I took it on the ass with the same wooden spoon that beat the cookie dough. No kid ever disappeared, and if they did, we'd never hear the sordid details of their death. Never landed on my doorstep. I was taught to be polite, how to eat and sit upright, but I was left alone to fight, figure out if that felt right. I think we got richer lives on our rusting no-speed bikes. I think we led safer lives when we played around with night.